Say hello to YouTube, do your thing, say something stupid, say Among Us, I don't give a shit. I went to SoCal Open. That is a pretty big, like 160 to 80 people tournament down in Southern California, since the name SoCal. I went there last year and I brought sisters, I think? I think I brought Sacred Rose sisters. Yeah, Sacred Rose sisters. And I'm back and I actually took Night Lords to the tournament. It was an interesting thing. I went 3-3 and I'm going to tell you about my games after I tell you about my list. I actually printed out this document for my opponent. It's very YouTubery looking. I added a lot of dumbness things in there, but I wanted to you know, go through it a little bit before. This is mainly so that they know what I do. So for Night Lords, we have our classic 9-inch aura leadership debuff. I gave them what all my marks do, of course, just to make it a little bit handier. As for my HQs, I only had two, which is actually a little bit rare for a lot of CSM lists. I had a Demon Prince and a Master of Possession. As you can see, I'm very much me in real life sometimes too. As you can see, I have Big Sword, which is the Hellblade, or Hellforge Sword, but you know, Big Sword. Zinchmark on the Demon Prince. I had the Murderous Reputation for 6 inches of turning off their Obsec. And I had the Mantle of Traitor's Relic for rerolling all my hits. A free strat once per game, which was always the cast a power and do a psychic action. And give something on the field reroll once to hit in the command phase. So the reason I like this one a lot is that the no Obsec Murderous Reputation was entirely to have my... Oh, he has wings too. Was entirely to put him on any of my like board side objectives and stop Obsec missiles from coming my way. I play sisters, and a very common tactic is to, hey, look, here's a bunch of Zephyrim or a Pensha. The Dogmatic gives them Obsec and go fucking run at them. Go kill everything on the objective, take it for yourself, and then, you know, rinse and repeat. So it stops the Obsec missiles in case that is ever a problem, which is very handy. The Mantle of Traitors was an interesting idea. Since CSM are very CP hungry, I thought, hey, often my Demon Prince is going to be using Psychic Interrogation because I can easier proc that free command point thanks to the Night Lord's leadership debuff. And for once, a game for free, that's pretty good. Rerolling all hits is nice to have, and this was mainly for my Terminator brick, which you'll see later. If they survive turn one, which they often didn't, but if they survive turn one, I can give them reroll ones to hit like across the way, which is great because they're a combo shooting and melee army. So some ideas, you know? The Master of Possession is as basic as you can imagine. Slaanesh Mark for the Terminator brick, revive and heal a model, spell Pact of Flesh, and then mutate invigoration. Nothing special there. Two squads of cultists. I will send them to die or hold the backfield. Like I said, I'm very honest with my list here. Two squads of legionaries. One has bolt, one chainsword, Slaanesh and Nurgle. These are for the special powers mainly. Another option for either prescience or delightful agonies, and then diabolical strength or putrid miasma, just to give myself a bit more. Also some more denies, which is always handy. As you see here, we have my enormous Terminator Thunderclock squad with 4 combi flamers, 2 chain, 2 power fists, the Black Rune, of course, Lamau, and the Slaanesh Mark. So the reason this is interesting, now normally when people run their giant Terminator squad, they often run it on the board and they have a Dark Apostle to give them illusionary simplification or whatever it's called. The reason why I like this in Night Lords is because Night Lords have a 1 CP stratagem to deep strike anything turn one. It's only 2 CP if it's Demon Kin. So this 10 brick of Terminators, if I get first turn, I will deep strike it turn one right there, like a drop pod in your face. And then I string them out, often over cover or close enough for my powers, give them all the buffs they need. And then I immediately sink with like 30 bolter shots and 4 flamers that all get +2 hits each because of Let the Galaxy Burn. It's pretty nasty, and it's something that people often can't, I mean, they can maybe deal with it, but it's such a gigantic, this is in your face turn one, yeah, maybe you'll deal with it fine, but you have to spend an entire turn doing that, and by then I'm running over the board. So it was an interesting concept. I liked them a lot, as opposed to taking them, say, in Word Bearers or Creations of Bile, Manly Bile. And I guess Emperor's Children too, but Manly Bile. Just plop them in their face. Five Chosen. I love Chosen. They have a Mark of Nurgle, which is a lot of fun. Also another reason for the Legionaries. Just five Chosen with a Mark of Nurgle are so efficient, dude. Bolter Fire, tons of powerful swords, three wounds, minus one to wound against anything worthwhile against them. It's really good. The Gat Master, Master of the Gat. This is the Master of Executions with the Slaanesh Mark, with Warp's Malice, with Night Hunter's Curse. God damn, it's so much fun. It's so much fun. He basically takes his goddamn Gat and he turns it sideways. And he dunks mortal wounds into you like mad. It is so much, it's so dumb. He is the main target for Diabolical Strength as well, to make him even better in melee. This guy dumpsters things. I did so much damage with him. I'll talk about it a bit later. So much fun. It's so dumb. It's like, I literally point at an enemy and it takes normally four mortal wounds. It's great. I point at an enemy and it takes many mortals and dies. Possessed. Mad I have to run them, not very Night Lords. The Possessed, unfortunately, are one of those things that are incredibly good in Night Lords. They have the minus one leadership aura. Their strength five means plus one to wound is really good against them. They're fast. Possessed are great. They're so fucking good in Night Lords. I hate that I have to run them because they're not a very... Night Lords don't like demons much. They find it like a crutch. And I don't want to run them, but, you know, I ran them anyway. Five-man squad. Fast attack, five raptors, actions, moving on the board, the usual. Venom crawler, it's a venom crawler. Warp talons, they're warp talons. These are all obvious. Havocs with four chain cannons. They go Burt, and then a rhino. I must admit, the four chain cannon Havocs were surprisingly good. Was kind of shocked by how solid they were. Mainly because often they were within range of my Demon Prince, and since the Master of Possession was often giving the Mark or the Delightful Agony to the Terminators, I was able to give them Prescience often with my Balefire Tome, especially with a plus one to cast by the Venom Crawler. And so I was running turn one, they would disembark from the Rhino, and they'd be hitting on twos, re-rolling ones with exploding sixes. 32 shots at 5 minus 1, 1 against anything that did not have Armor of Contempt. It was pretty nasty. I was kind of surprised. And then, of course, the Rhino was not bad. Important strats to note for my squad. 2 CP, no fallback. 2 CP, turn off your auras. Reactive minus 1 hit. That's that turn 1 deep strike with the Terminator brick. That was really good. The Slaanesh turning dice into a 6. T.O. said that it was unmodified for this one. It says we'll ask T.O. if so, Gatmaster, angry face. Fallback in charge and full rerolls to hit against leadership 5. This is Sound the Black Hunt. I went 3-3 overall at SoCal Open. How did those games go? Well, game one it couldn't have been more perfect. It could not have been more perfect. Game one was against Ulthway Eldar. Fucking Ulthway Eldar. Such a good thing because it is the main enemy faction in the third book of the Night Lords trilogy. And it was perfect. It was perfect. The main thing to note about his list was that it contained like seven seven Psykers Lamau, 10 Wraith Blades, Swooping Hawks, D-Cannon support weapons, and 2 squads of Banshees, among a few other things. The main thing with Ulthway Eldar was I got first turn, and I immediately dropped turn one with all my Terminators, give them almost all the buffs, and I just obliterated an entire squad of Dire Avengers and damaged a ton of his other things with sheer bolters and flamers. Because it was turn one, I can not too difficultly deep strike turn one and slaughter that stuff. The problem is that right after that, he hit me with every psychic power known to man. Jinx, Doom, he guided his friends, he executioned them, did all this stuff, and he dropped like all of my Terminators down to like four left after turn one. But he didn't kill them, which is why I walked up, murdered a bunch more, got the "we have come for you" so he couldn't fall back, but he eventually psychicked them all down, which was, you know, they died from just smites and executioner and all that kind of stuff. The main thing was his swooping hawks. The fuck? Oh, that was a steam key. Don't try to take that, chat. I already got it. Swooping hawks. I hate swooping hawks. I hate these things. I hate them. They are so fucking aggravating. If you don't know what swooping hawks do, they fly at you. They shoot you with a ludicrous amount of guns that I think auto wound on sixes. I'm pretty sure they auto wound on sixes, right? Let's double check this real quick. Eldari, swooping hawks. Here they are. Swooping hawks. Yeah, four shots each, unmodified sixes automatically wound the target. He had a squad of 10 of these. So he was putting out 40 shots and he was rerolling pretty much all of his hits with them. But the more important thing, after they shoot, instead of rolling a dice and moving them, they just deep strike anywhere else. So they would fly out, gun me down, and then go behind cover and I couldn't shoot them. They were such an ungodly annoyance. I couldn't stand them. I eventually shot them up a decent amount, I think, but I couldn't kill them all. The main interesting thing was the Wraith Blades ran up to the center of the battlefield and took the middle objective, and I killed basically all of them in one turn. They had everything. Fortune, the whole deal. And it was the blade and the shield. They had all of it. Doesn't matter when you got the Gap Master, when you run up to them and you shank them with Chosen, and you gun them down with Havocs, and you just wreck them. But the best part? They failed morale because I killed like six, or I killed like five actually. And then they had an extra minus three and they failed morale and he lost four. Four Wraith Blades ran to morale. And that was everything. That was everything. That was the day. That was the Night Lord fantasy. Maybe three of them ran for morale. Three or four. A lot. It was hilarious. Unfortunately, though, the game ended, I believe, at a 69-71 score. And that was me losing by 2 points. Or was it 59? I don't know. It was a 2-point loss. I honestly should have won. It was my secondary problem. I picked Sow the Seed, Reap the Fear, and got only 5 points from it. I think I did Psychic Interrogation and didn't get that many points from it either. And I did Assassinate because he had like 7 characters. The thing is I didn't know about Quicken because he took Warp Ritual, right? And so he ran into the center of the board, did it, and then launched himself back behind cover. I didn't know. I would have, if I had known some of these things, I would not have picked Sow the Seed. I would have picked Banners. Did not know about Quicken. Whatever the number was, it was 2 points. And yeah, I lost that one. If I had picked better, because I slaughtered him on primaries, but he did really well with his secondaries and I didn't. So if I had picked better secondaries, I probably would have won that one. But until then, wasn't able to, was unfortunate. But I think I can confirm I still hate Eldar. Second game. As if it couldn't get better. As if it couldn't get better. Lore accurate. The Blood Angels. The Blood Angels. I think two big squads. of Sangard, Death Company, Outriders was one of them, Sang Priest, I think, was it Lamardes? Maybe something like that. I think there were squads of 8 Sanguinary Guard. The Death Company were somewhat large. They had, you know, infiltrators, etc., that whole thing. It wasn't the full-on, like, 30 Sanguard. It was a combination of some Outriders, some Sanguard, some Death Company. This guy was, I believe, actually one of the members of XPZ, the Xenos Petting Crew. They are, I think they're based down near San Diego. There's a ton of them there. They made up, like, 30 of the group. There's just a ton. This game was a bit of a feels bad. I give a whole lot of respect for my opponents because things happened in this game where I think people would like throw models and he just looked mildly perturbed. The man had like an iron will. I was very impressed. He looked like a little annoyed and that was about it. I got first turn again, dropped my entire Terminator block, killed or damaged multiple squads, made my 9-inch charge, just ruined the squad of Outriders, stuck myself into multiple other squads and characters, and then I think his Death Company ran to morale as well as other things. We have come for you'd him. And I think my Terminator survived and then murdered the rest of that Death Company squad and so on. And then he charged me, didn't kill everything. And then more, I think he lost 8 Sanguinary Guard to morale and like 5 Death Company to morale. And at that point that was like, it was, his morale rolls were terrible. My save rolls were amazing. My charge rolls were great. I was rolling well and he was rolling like shit. It was an unfortunate thing. I think the game ended 90-30. It's one of those classic situations where would the game have been different if the dice were not as bad not as good for me and bad for him? Sure. Would that mean he would have won and I would have lost? I don't know. I don't think so. I think me getting that first turn charge off kind of sealed the deal right there with the 10 brick of Terminators. But it would have been a closer game. It was an unfortunate match because that was rough. He handled it really well, though, and that was awesome. But yeah, I don't think he rolled a single successful morale roll. Like, if there was a 6 to roll on morale, the man rolled it. It was very unfortunate. Fun game still, though. No, I guess I'm biased. Third game. Chaos Demons. I misspelled that. Demons. Zeech. Mono. Kind of interesting. Crazy thing about this. No greater demons. None. No Lord of Change, no Keepers, nothing. It was like 15 Flamers, I think. Like 3 Exalted Flamers. 2 Flamer Chariot thingies. Soul Grinder. And then like, I think 3 squads of blue horrors only. It was a really interesting list. I didn't know how good some Zeench shooting was. It hits. It hits hard. He had some HQs. I'd have to double check what they were. He obviously had some HQs. He just didn't have a Lord of Change. It was Mono Zeench. And I believe he had a change caster. I believe he had a change caster. He may have had a demon. He had a demon prince. Yeah, he had a demon prince. He had a Zeench demon prince as well. It was interesting. The main thing I was unaware of was I did not know Exalted Flamers had strength 9 AP 4 flat 3 damage guns. With 3 shots, that hurt. And he had like 4 of these guys because the Burning Chariots also had those guns. It was quite something. But the thing to note is that he had a lot of flamers. Now, if you don't know what flamers are, God bless you. Flamers are 3 wound, T4, 12-inch move, strength 5, AP 2, 1 damage flamers with D6 plus 3 shots for 25 points a model. And they have a 3-up save against shooting. They can take him in squads of 6. So for 150 points, you have 6 D6 plus 18 flamer shots at 5 minus 2, 1 damage with a 12-inch move, which can get plus 1 strength to strength 6 if they're next to an exalted flamer, which will also allow you to use a special psychic power to give them, add 1 to their wound roll. Combine that with their Warp Storm powers, which is army-wide, plus 1 to hit in the shooting phase, making every single one of those 9 at minus 4, 3 damage shots hitting on 2s, and a stratagem to max out the flamer shots on the flamers. And it was pretty horrifying. This is probably one of the most busted data sheets in the game right now. Like, it's gotta be top 5. It'll get nerfed. It'll get nerfed. Don't go buy flamers. It'll get nerfed. But, oh my god. However, this game very much went my way. He got first turn. He moved up and he kind of moved his, what was this guy called again? The Changecaster, too far towards the side, and he didn't properly screen him. So I launched all 10 of my Terminators directly onto the Changecaster because it wasn't screened, and I unloaded 30 bolters and 4 flamers into it. And don't you worry, it died. No 3-up save saves it from that many shots. It died. Past that, I just basically, like, I was close enough to get hit by 1 squad of flamers, but just 1. The other 2 were too far away. And so that Terminator brick just moved up and ate everything up. It shot the flamers. It charged the flamers. They even the Overwatch wouldn't stop them. The Havocs gunned down all of the Blue Horrors. And I kept on, I had this strategy in these games called the Cultist Party Bus. I basically just put my guys in my Rhino to protect them and give them some extra movement, unloaded them, and then put cultists in the Rhino, and then drove the Rhino onto the objective. So if they destroyed the Rhino, OBSEC cultists would get out and take the objective from them. And if they didn't, I would then missile the cultists into their backline and take it from them instead. It was pretty dumb, but it was surprisingly effective. And so after that, the primary and the secondary he was doing fine with, but the primary he just couldn't make it up. He didn't have any OBSEC and I had enough. I took the objectives pretty consistently and I kind of just pushed and pushed and pushed forward. I don't remember that game's entire, I think it was like 82 to 70 or like 86 to 72. I think it was like a 14 point difference. In my favor, I won that one. Not a crazy win, but a pretty good game. I now know that Zine's shooting is not to be fucked with. It was a lot. Oh, that's right. He also had screamers. He had like a squad of 2 squads of 6 screamers. I don't think screamers are very good. They're funny, but they're not very good. So that was day 1. Pretty good. You know, I was 2-1, and even my first game, I probably could have won if I just picked better secondaries. A mistake I won't forget ever again. Well, I will, but you know, not this time. Game or day two was against orcs, particularly Goth pressure orcs. We're talking two kill rigs. We're talking Gaz. We're talking the weird boy. We're talking Gretchen. We're talking Mega Knobs. Two Mega Knobs. Commandos. Beast Snaggers. The Beast Snaggers that ride squigs. Squig Hog Boys. Etc. We're talking the full goth world. Oh, also the horrifying war boss on bike with claw and thing that gets you more attacks if it doesn't reach damage phase. So, goths. I was unsure how to react to goths. I had not fought goth pressure in a while. But Night Lords are particularly really good against orcs because we operate on low leadership and, well, even the death kill of war trike, leadership 7. I don't even need raptors in order to bring him down to the +1 to wound thing. You know, Beast Snagga Boys, leadership 7, +1 to wound. Everything is leadership 7 in this list. Everything. Even Gaz is only leadership 8. Put Possessed next to him? Easy. So I took Assassinate, Sow the Seed, Reap the Fear, and something else I don't quite... I think Banners. I maxed Sow the Seed. I got 15 points. For the beating their leadership when I kill them in melee, them failing morale, falling back, or failing in action. I capped that. I'm shocked I capped that, but I capped that. 15. I think I also capped Assassinate, or at least I got really close. The thing is... See, I knew orcs hurt, right? I knew they hurt. I didn't quite know how much they hurt. Like, I wasn't quite sure how much. Wow, it's bad. Goths, they, wow. Like, wow. So I want you to think about this, right? Okay, so I roll up, right? All right, so I pull up, you know, hop out at the after party. And I fire my entire squad of Terminators right down there. I give them every buff. +1 toughness. 5 up, feel no pain. They have the -1 to wound. They're tough as shit, right? And then this guy just rolls up with the Death Killer Wartrike. No, he didn't roll up with that. He rolled up with something else. Thanks to the Warboss on Warbike. That sounds right. Yeah, that sounds about right. That kind of thing, right? And then he's got the giant claw, right? He's got the giant claw. He's got the killer claw. So it's like strength like 12, AP 4, flat 3 damage. Okay, that hurts. That hurts real bad. But then he rolls up with that warlord trait, right? That goddamn warlord trait, which is brutal but cunning. For every attack that doesn't hit the inflict damage phase, he gets to make an extra attack. And then, I'm just saying, Gaskell gives him like full rerolls to hit, right? And then, not only that, but he's goths, and goths get sixes to hit explode in melee. And on the turn that they fight, they get +1 strength as well. So, okay, you have all that. But then he hits me with the fucking psychic discipline, right? He hits him with Warpath. No, he doesn't. He hits them with, I think, Fists of Gork, which adds 2 to the strength and attack characteristic. And I think he made psychic text 11 or more. So I think he got 3. So this guy is rolling up, right? He's rolling up with, he also wad, mind you, with like 8, 9 attacks. 9 attacks, something like that. at flat damage 3, AP 4, with strength like 18 or something. And then he gives them the stratagem to have them explode on 5s instead of 6s. And Gazkul is on there, which gives him 4 rerolls to hit. So he just rerolls all of them. And so he ends up with like 14 fucking hits. And he kills 6 Terminators. We're talking minus 1 to wounds, T5, fucking 5 up feel no pain, Terminators. He just took his orc schlong and like smacked me in the face with it and killed like all my Terminators. And then after that, that was the end. Because after that, he brought in his Mega Knobs, who he gave Warpath. He gave his Mega Knobs Warpath, and they were also wad up. So that was another 30 attacks with full rerolls to hit. So yeah, my Terminators died turn one. And honestly, I was holding them off for a bit, not gonna lie. I was holding them off for a while, but it was like that scene is in The New Hope when they're stuck in the trash compactor. I'm just like, please. Ugh. Like, he just pushed. And then I pushed back and made half of his units run away, or, you know, just slaughtered him in certain other ways because he's not that tanky. And then I turned my Glock sideways. And, oh yeah, the Master of Executions basically one-tapped Gazkul. I smited him twice for 4 mortal wounds. And then I turned my gun sideways, did 4 mortal wounds, and then I ran up and stabbed him with my fucking axe and did like 4 mortal wounds. And he just died. He just killed Gazkul basically on his own with some psychic help. But I just couldn't stop him. He kept pushing on me and pushing on me and pushing on me. And I couldn't take it. The damage was too high. The Goths were too strong. And I think I lost kind of a similar score to this. I think he maybe got like 94 and I got like 81 or something like that. Or maybe I got like 74. It was a pretty great game. It was very fun to watch his guys just keep running away more and more and more. But yeah, Goths went to win the tournament. So Goth Pressure ended up winning the entire tournament. So obviously there's something pretty good here. Yeah, that was crazy. That was a crazy game. Really fun though. Orcs, I mean, come on. You know, capital B based. All right, 2 more games. Round 5. They didn't show up. I gotta buy. 3 wins, baby! 3-2, let's go! Hell yeah! Big money! They didn't show up. Yeah, they just weren't there. Yeah, win's a win, 3-2. Round 6. Demons again! This time, a little different. Bloodthirster. Lord of Change. 17 Flamers. Keeper of Secrets. Pink Horrors. And Exalted Flamer. Etc, etc. So, this was a rough one. This was the game I played the worst in. Let me make sure I didn't miss anything important off of this one. Yeah, because he beat me 98 to something, like 98 to 42. Let me make sure. He had a change caster, Bloodthirster, Keeper. He had 10 Bloodletters, you know. No, everything else was there. Change caster and Bloodletters. So this was rough. When they say that Warhammer is a game of inches, this is probably the best example I could possibly think of. He told me everything his army did. He told me everything his army did. But my only experience against demons so far was against this guy. So he told me every psychic power. He gave me every knowledge I needed to know. But I was having a bit of information overload. So when the time came, I didn't know that the Lord of Change and Keeper of Secrets had psychic powers that did not either require line of sight or required line of sight but ignored Lookout Sir. My Gap Master, turn one was mind fucked and murdered in the psychic phase. He was 1 inch away from being obscured by cover. If I had remembered, I would have moved him, obviously, but I didn't. I forgot. And so he just picked him right out of there. He went, boop. There it is. 2 CP, entire character gone. Just disappeared in the psychic phase. And now, yeah, I dropped my Terminators down, killed a whole lot of stuff, shot some stuff. He had a bunch of flamers, so they shot me back. The thing is he ran a different kind of Bloodthirster than most do. Now, he ran the Bloodthirster that has the classic 8-wound gap exalted thing. We can only do 8 wounds a phase kind of thing. But he ran it with a different kind of relic and warlord trait. He ran something known as Devastating Blow. Each time the warlord makes a melee attack, rules that ignore wounds cannot be used. So my 5-up feel no pain on my Terminator is gone. Gone. Disappeared. Removed. And then he also had, what was this, Argath, the King of Blades or something is what it said here. Yeah. Oh yeah. Argath, the King of Blades relic. +1 damage to his weapon. Ignores all modifiers to hit and wound. So Black Rune of Damnation? Gone. Completely removed. And if you don't know about the Bloodthirster's weapon, the Great Axe of Khorne is now damage 3. Terminators have 3 wounds. And so he made 16 attacks. He ignored feel no pains. He ignored minuses to wounds. And he just murdered me. The thing is that despite my Terminators getting fucked up, I was actually not doing terrible. I actually killed by stabbing his Keeper of Secrets to death in the second turn. And I was damaging the Bloodthirster. I even charged a bunch of horrors with warp talons to get rid of his obsec. And I made sure that nothing was in heroic intervention range, except for the warp talons, which were 1/2 inch too close to the Bloodthirster. And so the Bloodthirster heroically intervened and based me and killed all of my warp talons. And then flew over and killed all of my chosen. And that was it. Very similar to game 2, where even if things weren't like that, I still may have won this game. Like in game 6, even if I did measure for my Gatmaster and I did measure for my warp talons, I still probably would have lost because he was pretty good. I just probably wouldn't have lost 98 to like 44. 2 crucial moves, a poor heroic intervention measurement and a poor obscuring of my master possession, changed the game from what might have been like 80 to 70 to 98 to 44. Genuine game of inches, that one. So overall, that was that. It was a lot of fun. I had a really great time. SoCal Open is always a blast. I love playing my Night Lords. They're super fun. Things to note, would have taken different secondaries against Eldar. This was just a lot of dice shenanigans. Pretty proud of this one. Would have maybe changed up my shooting. Would have definitely committed to Terminators not so early against the Orcs one. Holy Christ, they did so much damage. Lola Mao. And Game of Inches, make sure you measure properly. If I were to change up my list at all, I would have definitely changed the Demon Prince so he doesn't get take the mantle of Traitors. I don't think it's that good. Probably no, none of this either. I may have taken the Killing Fury combined with the Nurgle Relic and Stem. The Terminator Brick is pretty good. Chosen's pretty good. Maybe I would have dropped the Raptors. They're very Night Lordsy, but they're not very good. I may have taken instead some more Possessed, perchance. Or maybe more Chosen, actually. I'm going to take more Chosen. I feel like you being 5 inches from staying outside for Heroic Rage is something you would remind your opponent. Oh, he did. He specifically stated, like, hey, watch for the Heroic Intervention on the Bloodthirster. And I did actually move out other units from being in range. But that was one of those kinds of things where, like, you know, it was very much the, like, I did warn you. He just, I can respect, like, at the end of the day, it is a tournament. I can respect the him not telling me every single unit that is in range. But he did call attention to it. He said, watch out for the Heroic Intervention of the Bloodthirster. It was fine. That was perfectly acceptable for me. No, I mean, he gave me all the information I needed. It was a bit of information overload. It was, he very much gave me my chance. So yeah, SoCal Open. If you guys want me to do these kinds of stream/video discussions again, next time I go to a tournament, let me know. I'll talk about it a bit more. Next time I go to a tournament, I'm probably going to take Votann, if I'm being honest. I just bought a whole bunch of the new models. I'm actually putting together a Yurani Surtur Regulus army. Pretty excited about that one. The toughness 5 is pretty cool. And so I might be hitting some of that going, you know?